The families of more than 500 Māori Battalion troops are to receive the war medals their loved ones missed out on. It follows one man's long campaign, which has already seen more than 130 soldiers finally honoured for their World War II service. Here's our Māori Affairs reporter, Te Aniwa Hurihanganui.
It was New Zealand's most decorated infantry battalion in the Second World War.
A Māori battalion arrive in the United Kingdom.
But 635 men from the Māori battalion never received their war medals.
Medals are now ready for those remaining families for whom they have not been claimed. And we will perform medal award ceremonies to acknowledge the service and the sacrifice of 28th Māori Battalion.
The families of 134 men from C Company have already been given medals after lawyer David Stone's work to track them down.
Massively moving, massively significant, full of emotion.
And he hasn't stopped looking, now identifying another 501 soldiers.
Some of the names didn't match up because they changed it, because they were young. They used uncle's names. It was one heck of an undertaking, but where there's a will, there's a way.
It's thought many didn't know how to claim their medals, and the Army accepts it didn't always know how to reach them.
The processes weren't in place to ensure that that was done in an appropriate and effective manner.
Just one member of the Māori Battalion is still alive, 97-year-old Robert Gillies.
All I can say is it's about time, and thanks to David Stone.
He says the medals are more than a token gesture.
My medals are a passport. Yeah, whenever they call us to go to a centenary or a celebration, I have to put the medals on.
Do they remind you of your friends
always,
in the battalion?
Always. Mm. When you go to put them on, yeah.
Not just recognition of service, but a tribute to mates no longer here. Te Aniwa Hurihanganui, One News.